ఆంత్వా గణపతి గుం హవామహే కవిం కవీనాముపమశ్రవస్తమం జ్యేష్ఠరాజం బ్రహ్మణాం బ్రహ్మణస్పత ఆన శ్రన్వన్నోతిభిస్సేదసాదనం ఓం మహాగణాధిపతయే నమః. ఓం బ్రహ్మాదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః. సర్వోప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుఖే నమః. హరి ఓం. శ్రీమద్ భగవద్గీత ఫస్ట్ చాప్టర్ వర్స్ నంబర్ 10. అపర్యాప్తం తదస్మాకం బలం భీష్మాభిరక్షితం పర్యాప్తం త్విదమేతేషాం బలం భీమాభిరక్షితం. యాజ్ వి సా ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ సెషన్, Duryodhana, who was talking to his Acharya Drona, while communicating to Dronacharya, he is expressing his nature and fear unknowingly. Now, especially in this verse too, he measures both armies. And also he is very particular who lead the army. He says, our army, which is led by Bhishmacharya, cannot be overwhelmed. That he wants to bring confident. Maybe he is not okay with that. Because when you fear an enemy, whatever that you possess, you may not be satisfied with that, or you may not be confident with those things. Though he has got Bhishmacharya, etc., etc., so many great warriors, legends, and valors, but doesn't matter. Therefore, no worldly object can remove our fear. Because being a kind of depender on all the worldly object, Duryodhana cannot be satisfied. He is not able to become confident enough within him. Therefore, he is just blabbering in front of Dronacharya as though he doesn't aware all of these things. He just making him understand for the sake of his own understanding, to bring cheer in him. He says that our army cannot be overwhelmed. Their army can be overwhelmed, and which is led by Bhima. Again, Bhima comes in his mind. Because our army is led by Bhishmacharya, therefore it is very strong. That army is led by Bhima, it is less strong. It means what? So for us, it's going to be a walkover. We will get, you know, confidently victory very easily. But the same words also gives one more meaning, because people also give one more meaning. Paryapta means enough. Aparyapta means not enough. Because, you know, when we use the word, we should know what and all the meanings can be understood by this word. Now he says, so our army is aparyapta, means not enough. But though they have 11 akshauhini, that's the measurement, this Kauravas, they had 11 Akshauhini army, Sena. Pandavas had only 7 Akshauhini Sena. And somewhere count is also given One akshohani means what? How many that all the armies, divisions are involved in it? He says aparyapta means that which is led by Bhishmacharya is not enough. Maybe because of less confident. But Swami, Pujya Swamiji means my guru, he doesn't accept it because Duryodhana was not that much ignorant. So, and he was also a great warrior. He meant that we have got enough army to defeat them in order to cheer up his acharya, Dronacharya. And paryaptam etesham, idam etesham sena paryaptam bhimana abhirakshitam. That army which is led by Bhima. It's paryapti means enough. Here he says that is their army is enough to fight to get victory over. That's what he meant. But though he was right to mean that, but it's kind of overconfident, not having the side of dharma, it is not possible. Whether it is seven akshohani or less than that, it would have been. But definitely Pandavas, definitely they will be achieving the victory. Because dharma was their side. Then he continues, even in the next words. Ayan eshu cha sarveshu yatha bhagam avasthitah bhishma eva bhirakshantu bhavantas sarva evahi. Then he continues, he gives order to all people. Ayaneshu means from all the divisions. It says that he says, so from all the divisions, being in your own respective positions, all of you just protect Bhishmacharya. Bhavantaha sarva evahi, all of you indeed, being in your respective positions, yatha bhagam avasthitaha, from all the divisions, protect Bhishmacharya in particular. Because he knows that till Bhishma is alive, nobody can defeat him. Therefore, Bhishmacharya, because you know, all these leaders of his side, Bhishmacharya being as a commander-in-chief of his army, so he wanted to protect physically and psychologically too. Because this Bhishmacharya and Dronacharya, Kripacharya and all of them, they really had the soft corner for Pandavas. Duryodhana, he knows very well, he doesn't want to give a chance for them to proceed with their soft corner. Therefore what? He wanted to protect, and also he knows the importance of Bhishmacharya. Therefore, he gives the instructions to the army. Please protect Bhishmacharya. Then the next words. Tasya sanjanayan harsham kuravraddha pitamahah simhanadam vinadyochaihi shankham dadmau pratapavan. So as he was giving instruction to the all army, then suddenly kuravraddha, the eldest person of Kuru, the grand, great grandfather, Pratamahaha, Bhishmacharya, started roaring terribly like lion and blew his conch. Uchaihi simhanadam vinadya shankham dadmuhu. Just he started roaring like a lion. He made a noise, you know. Then he blew the conch, his conch. And Pratapavan means who was known for his valor. In order to cheer up Duryodhana. Tasya sanjayan harsham. Harsham sanjayan. Tasya means Duryodhanasya harsham sanjayan. Harsham sanjayan means in order to cheer up or to make him happy, he shouted, means roared like a lion started blowing the conch. Now here also we can also understand this Pitamaha Bhishmacharya might have thought this kid is blabbering, you know, continuously for a long time, that too in the battlefield, this is not a courtyard, let us begin the war. That's what he might have thought. Therefore what? He began the war. See, blowing conch, it's a, the first call for the war. In those times, so they used to blow the conch. And even now, we blow the conch when we do puja. The sound of the conch, it is auspicious. And also this blowing conch, it indicates the yuddha, a war which is only for dharma, to protect dharma. And in the second chapter, even Lord Krishna says, Hatova prapsyasi svargam jitva va bhokshase mahim. If you are killed in the battlefield, definitely you will reach Swarga. Now you see, even in the battle, they followed certain rules and regulations with the proper attitude. The blowing conch is for auspicious. And they are converting because they fight for dharma, not for selfishness. Now, Pandavas are not fighting for their rights. Their rights, because they used to live more than, you know, 13 years in the forest already. Because being a children, when Pandu was there, they were in the forest alone. Being in the forest and living in the forest is not new for them. But they fought for dharma. That has to be the understanding. Because when we see, many people say that Gita, you know, it suggests to for a war. No, never. The Gita is a given context through which we can understand the situation about the life, the condition about the life. You know, in your physical body, every bacteria, there are good bacteria and bad bacteria. They fight each other. Sometimes, you know, good bacteria, bad bacteria, they overcome good bacteria. But many times, it means continuously, these good bacteria are fighting and defeating the bad bacteria. It's a fight. If we have the perception, so if we consider that's a kind of war, that's what life is. You have to kill in every breath that subtle, this, you know, minute bacteria. That dharma considers it. Therefore, what? When you begin your life, after initiation of Gayatri, so the Gayatri itself, it comes under Nitya Karma. Nitya Karma means what? That mandatory, it is compulsory to be followed by human being in order to neutralize these all papas which we have to commit for our survival. That's what, you know, taking all these small papa karya into account, we have fixed as Nitya Karya and Naimittika Karya and even Prayaschitta Karma too. Therefore, the life, the aspects of life is not only to survive, that aspects and aspiration of life has to be protect and to be lived with dharma. Therefore, Pandavas were fighting for dharma. This Bhagavad Gita, the context indicates life is nothing but war. And that's naturally we are endowed with that. So every decision according to Kathopanishad, Shreyascha, Preyascha, these two things which are called Shreyas and Preyas, they approach every creature, human being. We have the chance to select. Then Prayas means there he gives as Adhyatma teaching. But here, so two things through which you can commit papa through which you can commit, you can earn punya. Now that's what the battle is. Battle is not outside, it is inside. Inside in your mind, there are good thoughts, there are bad thoughts. You have to be endowed with good thoughts. That good thoughts which leads for dharma to follow. That's what our establishment is. Therefore, you know, this misunderstanding, I don't know how it has taken place among the people. It is not a war book. It's a book which teaches what to be understood in our life. Okay, these war situations and all these things are given for our mind to get ready for the concept. And don't think that it is provoking for the war. War means it's between dharma and adharma. So that's what the fact is. He says he blew the conch in order to show that this is called dharma yuddha. Therefore Bhishmacharya, when Yudhishthira came before the war to seek blessings, he blessed Vijayi Bhava. That Vijayi Bhava. So because of prarabdha vashat, because of his karma phala, he was the side of Duryodhana, but he fought and died for the sake of that kingdom. He followed, he could protect his satya, but his mind was blessing these Pandavas because they were side of dharma. That is the understanding which we should have here. Then when he blew the conch, the atmosphere has changed. And all other people from Duryodhana's armies, they also blasting so many instruments like Tatashankhascha Bheryascha Panavanaka Gomukhaha Sahasaiva Bhyahanyanta Sasaddastumulo Bhavat Tataha. Immediately afterwards, Shankhascha, all the conches of Duryodhana's armies were blew. Then Bhairyascha means kettle drum. All the kettle drums, Panava Anakago Mukhaha, Panava Anaka Komukhascha Vadya Visheshaha. All those musical instruments, but they are not musical instruments because they don't make melodious noise. They will make like a noise, like a sound, like a roaring lions. It's a hitting all over, that disturbing all the natures. Panava means tabards, and anaka means trumpets, gomukha means, there was an instrument called which was made by cow horns. All those sahasa eva abhyahanyanta. Immediately all those instruments were burst forth, means blast forth. Sasabdaha, that sound, it tore the sky, means it was like earth shaking. Now the war moment, war condition has been set. That's what, you know, now there is a kind of situation. The environment have been noisy to prepare for the war. But nowadays there is no precautions, no shankanada, just you hit whether they sleep or not, because there is no dharma at all. Dharma means we respect even to the enemy to get ready. Because both of us, enemy and me, we follow the rules. You know, till Bhishma's death, all the rules and regulations were followed properly, because only fight used to be on daytimes. In the night times, both sides people, you know, because they were relatives. So both side people, they used to go each other, and they used to have all this hospitality. They used to have food together. That was a proper war, the war which is governed by the law of dharma. But when Drona came, everything smashed. From that point, the war has taken a different dimension. Now here, that condition has taken place Then the next words, tatashvetair hayer yukte mahatisyandane sthitau madhava pandavas chaiva divyau shankhau pradadhamatuhu. Then from this side, Pandava side, this Madhavaha, Pandavaha, Chaiva. Madhava means Lord Krishna and Arjuna. Arjuna means Pandu, Panduputraha, Pandavaha, all Pandavas. And who were in the chariot which was driven by white horses? They also started blowing their divine conscious. Pradadmatuhu. Then the conscious are named in the next words. We will read it. Panchajanyam hrishikeshaha devadattam dhananjayaha paundram dadhau mahashankham bhimakarma vrikodaraha. Hrishikeshaha, Lord Krishna, his conch is Panchajanyam. He blew Panchajanyam. Then Dhananjayaha, Arjuna, he blew Devadattam, his conch. The name of his conch is Devadattam. He blew that. And Paundram Dadmo Mahashankham Bhima Karma Vrkodaraha. And this Bhima was called Virka Udaraha. Vrkodaraha. And he also blew his Mahashankham. Paundram was the name of his Mahashankaha. Then Ananta Vijayam Raja Kunti Putro Yudhishthiraha Nakulasaha Devascha Sughoshamani Pushpakau. And the son of Kunti, whose name was Yudhishthiraha, also known as Dharma, Dharma Putraha, Raja Yudhishthiraha, the king Yudhishthira, who was son of Kunti, he blew that the shakanch is known as Ananta Vijayam. Then Nakulaha and Sahadevaha, both brothers, they also blew their conches respectively. Sughosha Mani Pushpakam. See, all these Pandavas, they blew their conch. And the next words, Kashyascha Parameshvasaha Shikhandi cha Maharathaha Drashtadvimno Viratascha Satyakishcha Parajitaha. And all other kings, they also started blowing their conches. This is how it goes. But the war movement now, see, this war movement, when it was taking place, till now Arjuna was very normal. And all the people, see, who was named by Duryodhana, now also there are many more people are listed like Kashi and Sikhandi, Dhrishtadyumnaha, Virataha, Satyahi. Then also the names are mentioned, much more, many more names by Acharya Vyasa. That we will continue from next session. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.